I'm gonna eat some Triscuits real quick, so I'm gonna mute for a second. Oh, cool. 5 XP. Weird. Well, that every little bit helps. So it's worth it to deconstruct on the character that you're leveling. Hey, Jib Cutter, how's it going tonight? Hope you're doing well. I would imagine it's whatever type of essences you're getting that school levels up or gets the 5 XP. Yeah, each school is separate. So all the mind body stuff goes towards arcane, the good, lawful, etc. goes to divine, and then the fire, air, water, etc. goes to elemental. You have to be in the party chat window. There you go. Yeah, those should disjunct. Oh yeah, I do want to say also that the interface is buggy, and sometimes you have to close it down and restart. Restart it. For some reason, it just doesn't. Yeah, I forgot to tell you that. That happens all the time. It's really annoying. You get into the kind of the groove of getting your stuff out, then all of a sudden it does that, and you have to stop and restart it again. So yeah, if that happens, just close it and start again. Yeah, everything. Absolutely everything you can break down, do it. You'll want all those essences when XP bonus time comes around so you can level as much as you can in that one go. They can deconstruct the shards you don't want, do it again. Get more stuff. That's how I got these levels. They're about where I wanted them. I kind of want to change this character into an Artie anyway. Because Arties get the bonus levels for crafting per level. All right, cool. But yeah, you want a huge stockpile, see, because you're going to burn through them really fast when you start leveling your crafting. And plus, you need, as I said, a big bag to hold all your stuff. That seems nice. Paragon, is just what it says. So the plus six in the upper right corner is the like crafting value and the enhancements on it, basically. And those, if those add up to six or higher, then you get an extra plus half weapon die, basically, in damage. So you can see there it says damage is 4 to 12. It's 1.5 d6, 1 d6 instead of just 1 times 1 d6. It's 1.5 times 1 d6. So plus W is what you want to look for on weapon modifiers. Like deadly weapons gives you plus 1 W, I think. There's lots of enhancements and stuff that work like that, where if you're equipping the right weapon, then you get a plus weapon die, and that multiplier really helps your damage. Epic weapons have a plus one, I believe. Human or warforged on the Arty? I'm not sure what I would go. I think a warforged Arty at the moment. And that's pretty awesome. So I probably would think about sticking warforged on that. But I'm not sure. Obviously, there's good things with the having the Warforged, since you have the repair set and such. Crap. We can't get there from here, as Guildmate likes to say. So let's go Marketplace. And from here, is it easier to get to 12? Or Lord's March? It's about the same, isn't it? Let's just walk to Lord's March from here. So yeah, I think I would go Warforged. In fact, if I was not doing it for crafting, I might go Bladeforged and then take. Yeah, I might go Bladeforge if I was doing that. So I get the iconic, get right up to 15 and go that way. Where's the person? This one's flashing. Oh, there it is. Eyes of Stone. So this has a Medusa in it. Such. Oh, and that's another good point. If you're doing a crafter, you can take human and that dragon mark of making, which gets you even more crafting levels. So that's another thing to think about.
Tallis is waiting for you in the plaza as arranged. Yet the captain of the guard looks worried and agitated.
Bladeforge has lots of benefits. Self-healing is one of them. But the whole iconic thing starting at 15 and all that is good too. Are we going in this quest or are we doing something else? them all in here myself, and that's not gonna work. I'm gonna die, for sure. All right, hold on. Let me just go back out. Reset the quest. This guy we're standing right by. I know this is a weird area. In general. Yeah, Tolis here is the one we wanted. Reset the quest. Alright. Yeah. All right, let's get some buffs going. Let's see, we want the heroism and the blur and the retreat and the freedom. And back on me, I want some of the same stuff. Then we'll do some of that and that, and we're ready to go. All right.
Hollis is waiting for you in the plaza as arranged. Yet the captain of the guard looks worried and agitated.
Speak with the steward inside the palace. Is that up here? I completely forget how to do this quest. I remember the end, and I don't remember much before it. Nope. Not there. Oh, hey, look. Oh, that's right. The palace is the big door. That's right. I remember now. Yeah, I haven't actually played a Mage Blade Forge yet. Okay, we need to go get the salve to turn people from stone back to flesh. As I recall this quest. And there's some traps in here that... Yeah. So be careful, there's some traps in here. This does not look like the right area for the salve. Let's go back the other way first. We can't go that way, so let's go this way. This looks like the right area for the salve. Go back through the door you came in, and then go the way I am.
Bookshelves show that you have found the archives. A nervous woman crouches behind a table at the end of the hall.
Yeah, watch out when you kill those guys, they explode. I know there are traps in here, I just don't remember where they are. They're so hidden. Here? I don't know if I can actually find it or not. Nope. Displacement wore off. That's not good. And there's the salve.
You find the stone to flesh salve you need inside the strong box.
So I'll put that up here. So whenever you see somebody that's stone, you can I spot hidden here. But I do not have the search for it. There's one back there too, I think. Let's see. Right here. I don't know. There's one here somewhere. I don't know what they are, but I'm seeing the notice come up that they're hidden. I said I don't remember this quest enough to. There's another one over here, maybe. I'm not sure. That's where the thing that's going to be interesting here in a minute. Wow, that hit hard. That was fun. Oh, there we go. That's what I was expecting.
Somewhere, a distant voice intones, fire control system deactivated.
So here's a guy that's stone, and what you do is you use the stone of flesh on him, and then, hey, look, he's alive. And he's mad at somebody, so he helps fight. There's another hidden right here I'm detecting. I don't know what it is. Well, so yeah, you are correct. Back out this way. Oh, the bookshelves that open? Is that the one? I don't do this quest often enough to remember all this stuff. Oh yeah, there's some guys here, aren't there? Is that it here? Yeah. All right, now we go the other way that you were going to go. I think I still have the other one selected for some reason, which is weird. Yeah, I really should farm these for some of that stuff, because I want to get the wraps, the vampiric wraps created. So I really should farm that, all that fun stuff. Those are the common drops, then, Alright, we have everything cleared off except the side rooms. Let's start in the side rooms then. Yay, boss. I just haven't run this stuff much, so I don't know it very well. And like a lot of stuff that I don't know very well, I just don't run it unless there's groups. Now this one you should be able to see, I would hope. If not you, then me. No. Neither of us can see it. All right. Well, we'll have to do it the other way then. It's a hidden panel right here. I know what that one is. Or it's over here. It looks like it's that one. All right. We'll just go room to room then instead of taking the secret passages behind the rooms. It's not really a big deal. It's basically another way to get the same thing done. Oh, that's right, because it's the coin lords, and then you. The next part of this chain is where they're all sitting around in the palace, and you. That's right. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna be able to worry about that because we don't have that. Neither of us have thief skills. We don't have enough to search. There's no way we're gonna be able to pick. I don't have knock anything, I don't think. Yeah. Is that chest you're talking about upstairs here? Oh, there's a hidden right there. Just for giggles. Yeah, no. Actually, hold on a second. I've got Inspire Competence for you. And you've got that. Is there another skill check one? Yeah. I think I know which one you're talking about then. Oh, that's the lint drop symbol. I didn't realize that. I need to get back to focusing on me so I can heal. Yeah. I have, I think, two characters that I've played that could do traps, and I had really horrible experience with being in a party and them just being all pissy, basically, with me that, oh my god, your character build sucks, you can't do traps. Yeah, I've got my build is everything I could possibly have on traps. I mean, I had mechanic, I had the highest int whiz. It's a first life character without trapping twink gear. Yeah, what the heck do you expect? I was just. That turned me off of trapping for a while. Unreasonable hate. Oh, so it is worth. I was wondering if it was worth just coming here to ransack that one chest, but if the final chest does it as well, it's worth doing both.
You have freed all of the coin lords from the Medusa's curse.
Yay. Coin lords are done. Yeah. It's such awesome XP. Well, we don't have that, so let's go this way. Oh, we have to speak with dude first. I always forget which one your work was. Oh, he's the one I have selected. We went this way. Especially now that it's. %30. It's worth. All right. Got that. What doing up here? Wow. Where are you? We need to go upstairs. That's hilarious. That guard was scared. I think that's a whole screenshot thing. I think we're gonna, oops, take the UI off. Let's see, where do we want? Yeah, we'll just do it that way. That's screenshot worthy. That's hilarious. Yeah, I bet Skunk between the two. Probably doing a lot better. Yeah, he does look kind of like eek a mouse. No, I need to. Yeah, shrine. I'm gonna need that in a minute. Yeah, I don't remember which way we go. That's where we came, right? Looks like it. So we should go that way. Yeah, what the heck? We'll go over here and do this. Kill some guys, and then I'll go use the shrine. Why not go in if you're going the trapper route anyway? What else do we have to do? That would be definitely an interesting, different kind of build.
Kobold jeers as the gates slam shut. Perhaps there is another entrance.
Right. I believe that this is an interesting fight. That, let's see, now I probably can make it through this fight. Do we need to boss them out now? We should be good. Want to see something. Let's see. Well, I haven't really used the bluff, intimidate, and all that very much ever, so. Harper is just great utility. If nothing else, it's just some great utility stuff. A little bit of extra hit points, a little bit of extra spell points, that plus one against evil. That's true. Since you're barbarian, you do your rages, it does make more sense to rely on your strength than go into damage. So much good stuff in Harper that instead of taking just filler junk in some of the other trees, sometimes it's just better to go, you know what, I'll just go Harper and get something a little more generically useful instead of something situationally useful for my class trees. Help us fight these guys that blow up. So, watching you, the fact that you're just saving on all those makes me really want to redo my sorcerer into a paladin sorcerer. Just for that survivability. This couple, 2-3 levels of paladin to help that out. Probably just 2. Yes, it's a... Yeah, that's pretty ridiculous. I beat you on reflex, but I put a lot of work into reflex on here. Just to help be survivable, and then I've got uncanny dodge I can throw in to the mix as well. Well, you know what? I don't have displace on, which means you probably don't have haste on, which is a bad thing. Yeah, and I bet the ship buffs help a bit too. Probably helped get your stuff up just that little bit higher. 2 more palace guards for the bonus. There's another little. Okay. You know, I wasn't using the rune arm very much, but
ships as chunks of the roof fall to the ground. It appears that the invader's tunnel is dangerously unstable.
Then I actually started using it a bit. I remapped my key so I could actually use it. And I found myself using it a little bit more. I still don't use it a lot. It's good for breaking boxes, but I'm doing more of the not caster thing. So I got a collection of rune arms sitting there, but I haven't really mastered them. Also, I'm not sure what are you really supposed to do with the crafting bits on the room arms? Just like little utility stuff, like I don't know. Let's not use this shrine yet. Well, yeah, what the heck? Let's use this shrine. I don't know, it's because I have a lower level tier rune arms or what. It just hasn't done much for me when I've used them. But I don't cast much either, so really just pew 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 everything. 2 for this. Yeah, I figured. Me. Yeah, I have to detect secret doors as well. I forgot about that. Well, yeah, that part, I understand. I get that part, but what actually would you put on them? This is the end. We want to find those other couple guys to do that. I'm opening a door. There we go. Yeah, that's a good question, too. I was wondering if a third level paladin is worth it. I understand the 2 levels, but don't know if that third level is really worth it. What the heck, let's just finish it. I'm actually getting really tired now. What do you get at the third? Do you actually get turn on the third level? I know there was something you got on third level, Paladin.
A narrow
Oh,
tunnel filled with rushing
immunities,
water
that's
lies
right.
beneath the road. You could fit into the
So,
tunnel, but once inside, you
if
would not be
you're.
able to turn back. Yes,
Warforged
the
or
spirit
Bladeforged is
forces
probably not
stand
worth it.
before you. She
If you're
stands
human, it probably
unconcerned
might.
on the surface, but her
Those last
spirit
two guys are in
spirits
here, that's
wail
right.
in your direction.
There's a
You
timer on it,
free
that's right.
all of the palace guards from their
Yay,
spell
extras.
traps.
What? Don't hit that D-door. I messed up. That was supposed to be a ball, not a D-door. Why do you do that? I'm healing myself. Sometimes you just hit the wrong spell. Nope, you're dead. I didn't see that. Okay. So, where are your, is your stone? There it is. Pick up the stupid stone, you piece of crap. Having difficulties here. Hold on. Did I get the stone? No, I didn't. Because all right. Ah, freaking stunned. Oh, I was almost there. Almost there. Well. I don't think there's any way to survive that without us getting full stones and all that. Oh, the orb gives you plus four saves. Yeah. Yeah, I'm thinking release. We'll just. Oh, that's the other thing I should have told you to, is to bind on the ship. It's a lot faster to come back from stuff when you're bound to the ship. So wherever you're bound, find the nearest ship portal, come back to the ship, and I'll show you where the bind point is. So it sounds like that third level of Paladin really is kind of worth it. Particularly if you're not Warforged or Bladeforged. One of the buffs on the airship gives you really fast healing and spell point regeneration. Yeah, that's just handy. I guess it also depends on what you run. If you run a lot of content that's fear and disease, then it's a no-brainer. You should take it. So click the amenity bar and you'll get your fast regen all healed up. And then come over here. See, this is the right door? I think so. And first lower deck again. And then I'll show you on the ship where it is. You can just find me. Hello, lag. Yeah, I don't know. I think it would be handy, but I'm not sure how handy it would be if it's worth giving. I don't know. Yeah, what people usually do, what, 12 or 14 footer? Yeah, bind there at him. And then you'll be back on the ship instantly when you release, and it's a lot quicker and easier to do stuff. Like, let's see, is that the right room? Yeah, walk into that room over there. Next to the parrot. It's breakables in it. Sorry, that was cruel. One of two ways you can die on the ship, though. The other one is this cannon here. He has a control box here by this cannon if that's on, and sometimes people just turn it on so that you, when you come in, you'll come around this corner and wham, dead. It'll hit you. All right. So do you want to try that again or do something else? We could stoop to using hirelings to get through that quest. A little extra firepower and damage spreading. You actually want to finish it? We can go back in and finish it. If it hasn't reset by now. Airship. The guy up top to 12. We'll go Lord's March real quick and see if we can catch it. If you don't want to. We can retry. I don't care either way. We'll get an XP penalty for re-entry, but it's 10%, I think. Oh, we reset. Never mind. So, do you want to do hirelings or just go back in and now that we know what we're doing, maybe do a little bit better on the end fight, make sure we're ready for it? I'm cool either way. Do I have any summons? Okay. That's cool. We have confidence we can do it. We gotta start over, reset. Out just a little bit too long. I don't remember what fighter gets at 18 either. But.
Tallis is waiting for you in the plaza as arranged. Yet the captain of the guard
You
looks
could all,
worried
yeah, you
and
could also do a third
agitated.
glass if you want. Do something else. I'm not sure what else works well with Paladin. Well then, if you. Oh yeah, more feats. Well, that's, I guess if you think the feats are worth taking, that would be the big reason. But if you don't think they're worth taking, then don't bother with it. What? I thought I selected me. Oh, did I just double buff you? I just double buffed you, didn't you? Which I'm sure you appreciate it. It's a waste of my spell points. All right, good enough. Okay, then, yeah. Just kind of depends on what you want. But if you don't feel like everything is good there, then there's no reason to take another. Not to take another level or however many you want of Paladin. Well, the next thing you get is like what, five? Paladin level 5 gives you something else. I thought, hey Pog, how's it going? How are you doing this evening?
The audience chamber is strangely quiet. There's no trace of the coin
Yeah, if you hit
anywhere,
X, you'll see the
and the
XP thing,
amazing
and that you
statue
can confirm
standing in the
that it
center of
is
the
elite.
room.
All right, so the way we want to go is straight ahead, the one that's open.
Row upon row of bookshelves show that you have found the archives. A nervous woman crouches behind a table at the end of the hall.
Enhancement. Oh, the XP button over here on the right side of the screen. On my screen, anyway. With the recall button. However, you have that set up to hotkey, I don't know. We'll tell you what difficulty you're on. Actually, I didn't look at that. Yeah, you get the plus 80% for being on elite. Negative 25% because of the level, but we're not getting the bravery bonus, obviously, because we're over level, but still, first time completion bonus is pretty decent. Oh, these bookcases, what you're saying, we were, I get it. These were the things that were hidden. I understand now. Well, Twitch is, a lot. I didn't like the fighter 18 one enough to worry about it. I believe it's not something I used. Let me check. Let's see, what does it say? I only have 0.37 drop frame percentage, so it doesn't look like it's me. It's probably Twitch. I know this past week, especially, I've had quite a few streams I've been watching have that problem.
Stone to flesh salve you need inside the strong box.
I need to remember to put my emotes on my other character since this is where I'm keeping them. Doing all the card stuff. So yeah, if you have 4 levels, then 3 levels of Paladin might make sense, or 2 levels. And 2 levels of something else. Oh. I know my sorcerer, I'm tempted to take that 3rd level of Paladin if I do that. Which I think I might just TR into, or IR into, sorry, not TR, IR. Into a Blade Forge on my sorcerer. And see how that works. Made it through. Time to fleshify some coin lords. It's this way, isn't it? See, what would you get with one level of bard? They're charisma based, one level of cleric, one level of sorcerer. Just trying to think of other charisma stuff that might be useful. Six paladin could work. What do you get with six paladin? I was just looking at paladin last night because I was thinking about it for my sorcerer, and I cannot remember what you got at five or six. You got something. Think six paladin would work well. I don't know. I thought charisma was main for paladin, so I wouldn't know really what that would do for you or not do for you. Hey, look, you got it. Why this time are you? Oh, no. Why would you be seeing or this time and not last time? That's weird. So we can get the extra stuff back here somewhere. I'm seeing the door this time. Ah, DD base P. That's cool. That might be worth getting then for that. Is this the end? This is the end. That's York. We need to rescue the other two coin lords. Let's go back this way and get all the secrets. Then, since we're seeing her. There's the chest you were talking about, wasn't it? Yep, and it's locked. No bells of opening or knock scrolls or anything that would make that open up for us, fortunately. Just time for displacement to wear off. Probably haste. Air limits are so annoying. There we go. Yeah, I don't have any bells on me. Okay, we got the coin lords. Actually, how many points do I have? How many points is a bell? Because if that really drops that good stuff, that might be worth using a bell on. Where'd that chest go? Most of us are on sale. Hello, DDO store. Why are you not opening up? Let me check inventory real quick, too. While that's loading, pretty sure I don't have any bells. Those are probably in bank somewhere. I don't use a lot of that stuff. Usually save my TP for adventure packs and storage space and bags and stuff. 40. Eh, what the heck. I'll buy a quick bell opening here. I'm pretty sure I made at least 25 points today, so. So here the problem is I'm supposed to click a button I can't see. Wow, store is really not working well. Store is really not working well. I'm trying. There we go. Bell of opening. Do I have to use this way? Yeah. Chest, meet bell of opening. Hey, look, it's open. I got Gorgon armor. Do you want this armor? Because I ain't going to use it. I'm not gonna use that either. Oh, you got. Oh, did I? That's the lady did. Did you get anything? No, you didn't. Dragon touch should be better. I really should probably keep some Nox scrolls on this character. What's my UMD now? I got 41. I should be able to use Nox Scrolls no fail. Pretty sure. Thanks, Soccer. Where are we going? We're done with this now, right? Let's see. Find a way to Medusa Slayer. Yes, we are. Yeah, I think this is going to be the last quest for me tonight. I am definitely slowing down. Oops, didn't see that guy. Let's help you with your salve. Is this the wrong door? Is this the right door? This is the right door. No, after this, we're going to finish this quest, but after this quest, we're going to go. My eyes are starting to get heavy and all that. I really could use help with these guys. I Didn't realize you weren't right next to me anymore. I thought he said helicopters, not interlopers. Wow. There's a couple different ways to do it. Basically, don't dump charisma is the easiest, cheapest thing. I'm going to go ahead and use the shrine now this time. And save that other shrine for the very end. So this character has a 35 charisma. It's a bard, so level ups every level, basically. I've got 19 ranks of UMD, plus the 15 from that, and I probably have a plus UMD item or something. Good luck bonus, there's something I have, I'm pretty sure, that would help with that. So yeah, there's certain classes have advantages to get high UMD. It was a struggle on my fighter to get higher UMD, even just enough to get some of the scrolls and stuff, the common stuff to work. It was quite a bit. This guy's funny. All right. I don't think you need to trigger the other side. We just need to get this lever here. Lever, lever. Did you already get the lever? Oh, you got the lever. Okay. Somebody got the lever.
The kobold jeers as the gate slams shut. Perhaps there is another entrance.
I ended up buying a plus 4 tome of UMD, I think, on my fighter. Just so that. Excuse me. Just so that in epics, I could actually have a better chance of using raised dead scrolls. Even if it's not a cross class skill. You tank all the ranks in it, and keep your charisma as high as you can, and yeah, for some classes it's rough to do it, but it can be worth it depending on what you're trying to do with it. If nothing else in epics, people expect you to have some way to res them if they die. Whether it's a green steel clicky or raised dead scrolls, or the that ring that drops in the Restless Isles. Is that Restless Isles? I'm thinking of them. I think so. Some way of rezzing them. You got him. But even as a fighter, once you're level 28, I mean, the other thing is, you know, epic levels, you get skilled from there. Not on my fighter. On this one, yes. On my bard here that I'm playing, I did. It's a bard. Everything I have is charisma. That's not what I wanted to do. Strangely enough, that's not what I wanted to do either. I want to heal me. Thank you. Alright, so we need to go, let's see, this way. So yeah, this character has all the charisma I could get, basically. Did we miss a section over here? I think we did. Yeah, we missed this place where they're, whatever the heck it is. Yeah, can I get the door now? I don't necessarily want to fight them by myself, but yeah, I mean, it makes sense to do it. Plus, I've got, you know, charisma to damage now since swashbuckler and all that, so it's very worth it. As I said before, I don't know if you were on earlier when I was talking about it, but this character used to be my Haggle Bank character, and it wasn't really meant to play very much. So I took things like, anywhere you could bump up Haggle, even if it wasted a feat slot, I did. So I rebuilt it. I don't think I have that anymore. I forget now. But I rebuilt it with Swashbuckler, and it's a lot more survivable and playable now. Before, it was basically just a buff bought for the party, and was
Shifts,
primarily just for
parts of the
banking,
roof
and
fall to the ground. It appears
I wish it would
Captain
stop doing
Raven's
that.
company is dangerously unstable.
Wasting my spells on those guys. Now I can at least solo below level, or sorry, solo when I'm above level, if not at level. I think you just keep blowing up those kobolds in the area, and they'll eventually close it. Sort of got to sit there
The
and blow them
tunnel
up. There you go.
collapses, crushing everything inside. No more Droam troops
That's
will
it.
enter the palace by this route.
So yeah, let's see. I also have a +2 tome. The shrine is after this, isn't it? Or do you mean you want to go back and use that previous shrine? Which is fine. Think we're about to come up another shrine, though.
This dusty
Oh, that's the
chamber
shrine I was thinking
appears to
of.
be some sort of maintenance room.
Yep, you're right. What's that other way then? Okay, we didn't need to go, did we? No, we're good. Yeah, let's shrine. I'll go ahead and shrine as well, just to get my spell points back up to full before we do this last fight. Make sure I get all the buffs on both of us. Okay. So you need. That's for both of us. Come back to me so I can get most of those. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do these songs. And this song, and then. Actually, you know what? I should have buffed you before. I didn't think about that. All right, ready to go. So yeah, and then I've got Tome in there. My enhancements give me more charisma.
A narrow tunnel filled with
There's several
rushing
ways to get
water lies beneath the grate.
charisma fairly
You
high.
could fit into the tunnel, but once inside, you would not be able to turn back. Hestis the Medusa stands before you.
Okay, we
She
want to get
seems
these
unconcerned on the
guards up.
surface, but her snakes hiss and glare in your direction.
And then want to get my dancing ball up. Okay, now go. Now we can get into the fight. Hopefully this will help a little bit. Should help us get some of the trash knocked out. Which is our highest priority, I think, isn't it? Or does the trash respawn? I don't remember. Get that trash out, let me concentrate on her. I think we need to use the mirror trick, although we could if we wanted to. Oh, yep, there's more guys. Oh, she's almost dead though. Course, and there's some archers which do not respond well to ball just sitting there. My intimidate on my fighter is pretty low. Well, look at all those scrolls that I don't care about. Hey, you got rock splitter, that's cool. Legendary victory, that's also good. If you don't want it, I'll take it, but I don't think I really need it. Although, heavy pick. But it's for combining with other stuff. Go ahead and take it if you think you're going to use it at all. It's part of the crafting in this area. Right, I'll take it. There's just the one chest at the end, and we didn't get the wraps. So that's it. So good completion. Another 12k XP. Good stuff. So yeah, guys, I think I'm gonna call it here. So thanks everybody for watching. Thanks to Bara slash Stack Mechanic for playing. Let's see what the end reward is here. Something good maybe. Or complete crap, you know. I'm just gonna take the heroic deeds because I don't really worry about the other stuff. And are we ready to do this part next? Yes, we are. So after you talk to the other person, talk to Darman here. And now you can get the better stuff. We got the mark, we got robe, docent, staff, blade. So yeah, gosh, really. Yep, it was a fun night. Got to do some discussion of different builds and game mechanics, and always enjoy that. So thanks everybody. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it. If you haven't already, I would appreciate you following me. It's always fun to be notified when I start streaming, so you can catch me for sure, or at least be informed when I start. You'll see me on DDO stream Tuesdays at 5 p.m. Eastern, and on my channel here other days of the week, various times on various games. So yeah, do appreciate follows here on Twitch, subscriptions and likes and favorites on YouTube, Twitter, whatever you want to do there. My website. I promise someday I'll write more articles, and then on Steam. So again, thanks for watching and good night.